when we start seeing the first signs of plastic pollution in the ocean. I don't think we realized it was so huge and impacting marine biodiversity, water quality, and even our own health.
We know that microplastics are widely dispersed in the marine environment, right from the sea surface down to the seabed, thousands of meters beneath.
If we look at the amount of plastic waste that we generate in Europe every year, that's about 400 million tons, and that doesn't include the waste that we export.
Microplastics are very small pieces of plastic, typically less than 5 millimeters or so in size.
Sometimes they're naked to the human eye, sometimes they're found strewn across our beaches. It can come from clothing, it can come from larger plastic products, it's just been broken down.
Dans certains produits cosmétiques, on trouve beaucoup de microbilles plastiques qui sont très néfastes pour l'environnement et totalement inutiles. On pourrait s'en passer.
This is one used by men, and 2.8 million pieces of microscopic plastic are from a single container. We know that a range of marine creatures are eating plastics, and then if we look in the laboratory, we can see evidence that ingestion of microplastics can reduce the ability of organisms to feed in the normal way.
They can often make animals feel full because they're just sat there in their stomachs, unable to digest it, which prevents them from eating, and then they subsequently starve.
We don't yet know really how long it will take plastics to degrade in the environment. We've been making plastics for about 100 years. The suspicion is that all the plastics we've ever made are still with us on the surface of the planet unless they've been incinerated. Many of our uses of plastic is for single-use items, so a very short-lived benefit to society, but a very long-lived persistence as waste.
The problem with plastic in our current economic system is that we use it in an extremely linear way. We produce it, we use it, and then we throw it away.
We need behavioral change. We need to make sure that products are designed to minimize their footprint while they're being used, but also to make sure that the plastic can be recovered at the end of its lifetime, ideally by recycling.
In many cases, it's quite difficult to actually recycle plastic waste because it contains so many different types of plastics. And that makes the recycling process extremely challenging and extremely costly. One of the best options that we have right now is to convince companies to use more recycled plastic. For them, it saves money. For us, it protects the environment.
At Ecover, we're a manufacturer of household cleaning products.
At a certain time, we kind of realized that indeed the big threat to oceans and water quality was not only, of course, the chemicals we were using, but it was also the kind of packaging we were using to transport the product.
We want to make sure that the plastic we do use is as considered and as conscious as we can make it.
First of all, making sure all our packaging is fully recyclable. But even more importantly, we've committed to make all our current bottles out of 100% recycled content.
At Ecover, we're testing and pioneering plastics which are designed to be biodegradable.
European consumers can really look to their own use of plastics, looking to make sure that when they do use plastics, they get suitably recycled and seek out more sustainable alternatives.
If you provide the right incentives, consumers are ready to shift towards more durable models and kind of reuse their bottles, reuse packaging more than once.
Der Freiburg Cup wurde ins Leben gerufen, um einfach ein Alternativsystem anzubieten, um diese große Flut an Einwegverpackungen versuchen einzudämmen. Wir bieten dem Bürger die Möglichkeit, keinen Einwegbecher zu nehmen, sondern einen Pfandbecher. Und dieser Pfandbecher kostet 1 Euro. Bekomme ich in dem Geschäft, wo ich ein Heißgetränk mir mitnehmen möchte und kann den Becher aber an verschiedenen anderen Geschäften, die mitmachen, an der Aktion wieder zurückgeben.
Unseren Kunden gefällt das Freiburg Cup Modell sehr gut, weil es somit, sie können etwas für die Umwelt tun und das tun sie auch sehr gerne.
Consumers are pushing really hard with retailers to reduce the amount of plastic to be found on the shelf. And then, of course, the retailers get to the brand saying, hey, we need solutions to have less plastic.
Le Day by Day, donc c'est une épicerie qui vend que des produits en vrac. Donc vous pouvez venir avec vos contenants et vous vous servez juste la quantité qu'il vous faut. J'ai ouvert il y a 2 ans, donc ça se passe très bien. Ma clientèle est fidèle. Et donc l'absence de plastique et d'emballage plastique ne pose pas du tout de problème, au contraire.
I do think it's time now for government as well to impose more supply responsibility. Definitely in the future we'll use plastic more wisely because there's such a big momentum now. Clever businesses will look for models that will use a lot less plastic.